oxygen, life giver. Aside from a small number of bacteria and some single-celled species, all life on planet Earth needs oxygen. But what if that oxygen was under threat? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer all manner of queries, from science to science fiction, from popular culture to horror fiction and history. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and today I'm asking, what if the oxygen expired? Before we breeze on into this video, I want to ask you guys, wait for it, I want to know what your favourite element of the periodic table is. Yes, what a question. I feel like that question is not asked enough, but if it were asked of me, I would say without hesitation, neon, obviously. Let me know your periodic thoughts in the comments section down below. Also, please do like this video and share it with a friend. If you want to read more about the topic, then our sources are linked in the description box, and you can also find links to the people that went into making this video. So what if oxygen expired? Well, let's clear a few things up. Oxygen doesn't expire. An oxygen particle is very stable. It remains an oxygen particle. Yes, it can change states like other elements. Oxygen can freeze, but it has such a low melting point that it isn't really relevant. For the sake of teaching you something new today, I will tell you though. Oxygen freezes at minus 250 degrees Celsius or minus 355 degrees Fahrenheit. Those temperatures are not experienced anywhere on planet Earth. They never have been and likely never will be. If we are talking about oxygen as a breathable gas, that doesn't expire either. Breathable oxygen, O2, is stored for medical purposes and it does not go off. A tank of oxygen from World War II would still be just as effective today. Good, so we don't have to worry about oxygen then. Well, no, not exactly. Here's the thing, our atmosphere is leaking oxygen. Atmospheric escape is the name given to the loss of atmospheric gases into outer space. Basically, oxygen is moving away from planet Earth and into the bounds of the universe. Our atmosphere is leaking at 5 times 10 to the power of 25 molecules per second. You do the math. I can't. I'm busy. At that rate, it will be billions of years before it's all gone, but we are also using up more oxygen than ever. It seems that by analysing air bubbles trapped inside ice in Greenland and Antarctica, our oxygen levels have dropped by 0.7% in the last 800,000 years. In fact, back when life was really starting to, you know, come to life around 300 million years ago, there was significantly more oxygen in the air than there is now. Air isn't just oxygen, it's made up of a number of things. Oxygen is what allows us to function, but air contains just 20.95% of it. There is also 0.04% carbon dioxide, 0.93% argon, and 78.09% nitrogen in the air. Back in prehistoric times, there was between 30 to 35% oxygen in the air, depending on what period you're focusing on. This means that animals living today are living with around 14% less oxygen than the first animals. Could we survive with 14% less oxygen than there is today? In short, no. Humans need a minimum oxygen concentration of 19.5% to stay healthy. When oxygen concentrations drop from 19.5 to 16% and you engage in physical activity, you do some exercise, you go for a run, you pop out to the gym, you engage in any kind of physical activity, at this point, your cell will fail to receive the oxygen needed to work properly. Mental functions will become impaired and respiration intermittent at oxygen concentrations that drop from 10 to 14%. At these levels, with any amount of physical activity, the body would be absolutely exhausted. With oxygen levels much lower than 14%, humans will really struggle to stay alive and healthy. We will officially become oxygen starved and die with levels at 6% or lower. So basically, as oxygen seeps away, we and other animal life would die out. In fact, we likely would be some of the last to go because of our efficient lung capacity. The worst thing that we could do, the worst, would be panic, because panicking consumes more oxygen than ever. It consumes oxygen at a very high rate. Although on a grander scale, you know, actually, whatever, never mind, panicking won't change things anyway. We will continue to leak oxygen, but it will take a few million years for us to even begin to feel the effects, and then a few million more before it starts to impact our health significantly. In that time, it's likely that humans would adapt, or something better suited towards the new environment will evolve. You may remember the video I did about that big dragonfly that lived in prehistoric times, the Meganeuropsis. Well, back then there was over 30% oxygen in the atmosphere. It couldn't live today. Humans are pretty persistent, I'll give us that. Perhaps we would fight to stay alive, and perhaps we would actually eventually start absorbing oxygen in a different way. Perhaps we would actually start needing less. could we manufacture breathable air as an option? Well, right now that is pretty hard. We could try and mine oxygen from the earth because actually it's pretty abundant. If we look beyond oxygen as a gas, it's one of the most abundant chemical elements on our planet. It's plentiful in the ocean, obviously. Water is 2 parts hydrogen and 1 part oxygen. On top of that, about 1/2 of the Earth's crust is made up of chemical compounds containing oxygen. Right now, hydrogen and oxygen can be separated by passing an electric current through water and collecting the two gases as they bubble off, but this uses a lot of electricity and we don't have the resources. Also, we need O2 to breathe. Interestingly, it is theorized that for the first few billion years of its life, Earth's atmosphere didn't actually have any oxygen at all. Scientists believe that tiny algae called cyanobacteria evolved and triggered a very quick rise in oxygen levels. Perhaps we can encourage the growth of algae to gain more oxygen, but then too much algae is bad too. It's a fine line. Earth's losses of atmospheric gas is just another way that our planet is changing, and ultimately, planetary forces and cosmic sway much bigger force than human intervention. Ebb and flow is natural order. That being said, we really don't need to worry about the loss of oxygen right now. Like I said, it will be millions of years before it becomes an issue, and we have no idea what the future of planet Earth might look like at that time. There are other more pressing matters threatening human survival right now, like nuclear war, for example. So on that jolly note, I think I will leave this video here. If you haven't yet let me know your favorite element in the periodic table, then please, go ahead and do it. I, for one, am all about a noble gas. Science chat is good chat after all. Before I go, I'm going to read some comments from a recent Life's Biggest Questions video that I did. You had some great thoughts on what if the Meganeuropsis did not go extinct. Ah, big dragonflies. Ah. Batman Forever said, "Yay, it's my favorite host, Rebecca. Yay, Rebecca. Yay, giant insects. Yay, I'm running to the top of Mount Everest, lol. Listen, they can fly. They'll find you." Wolfbane said, "A spider is my favorite bug." They're not bugs, but I think that's what you're saying. "I'm terrified of all of them, and I have a heart attack when I see one, but they kill wasps and mosquitoes, so I like them. If we're talking actual bugs, then I really like dragonflies." I know what you mean. Like, I am freaked out by spiders because they just have too many eyes and legs, but at the same time, I don't want to kill them because I really like their work. And yeah, things that fly, honestly, like, I understand them and I'm happy to let them live, but just like, don't live anywhere near my face. Thank you. Terrific said, "What if we met an alien but didn't realize? What if aliens didn't look how we think they do?" Honestly, I think that's a great question. We have a preconception of how aliens may look in our mind, but we don't know. They could turn up on Earth without us noticing, and we might be like, "Hey aliens," without even knowing that we're saying, "Hey aliens." Honestly, hosting these videos makes me quite exhausted. I'm gonna go home now and consider noble gases. Lovely, lovely noble gases. Guys, please do like this video and share it with a friend. If you haven't yet clicked on that big, beautiful notification bell, then go ahead and do so now. Why not join our Life's Biggest Questions family? We love answering your questions daily. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, please do stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.